Gotcha! You're a pessimist. Why else would you watch this video? Sheer curiosity, perhaps? Maybe. I guess you might just be one of my subscribers. That's possible too. Either way, for the sake of the subject, just play along, okay? Thank you. Okay, so just to make sure we're all on the same page, what exactly is a pessimist? A pessimist is a person that always has a negative attitude, expects the worst out of people and of situations, even if the facts or circumstances indicate the opposite. They see the glass half empty, but they ignore the fact that it's also half full. They stress the negative, believe the evil in the world outweighs the good, and usually feel unable to control the things around them. Most people would never consider themselves pessimistic, but many of them are willing to admit that they're not optimistic. That kind of denial is a big part of their problem. The main difference between a pessimist and an optimist is the way they explain setbacks. An optimist will explain it in a way that convinces themselves that it's a changeable event. There's hope in their words, so they're motivated to take action. A non-optimist might explain the same setback by giving a more fixed explanation that makes them feel defeated and keeps them from even trying, which in turn makes the explanation come true. As you can see, both optimism and pessimism tend to become self-fulfilling prophecies. I've noticed that many people out there tend to confuse pessimism with depression. These people are poorly informed. Pessimism is a temperamental trait, whereas depression is a clinical disease. Sometimes, a consistently pessimistic attitude can lead to depression, but that's certainly not the rule. Pessimism is also easier to deal with. It can be willfully changed if you put in enough effort. But there's nothing anyone can do if the pessimists themselves don't acknowledge their pessimism as a problem and don't want to change. Fair enough. Then here are 26 techniques that you can use to change your negative attitude. The first place to start is anti-negative thinking, rather than jumping right into positive thinking. It's extremely hard to think positive when you feel negative. So for the time being, it's best to just figure out what's wrong with your negative thinking, what causes it, and then work on correcting it. At this stage, understanding and in time avoiding pessimism is much easier and much more important than embracing optimism. What you have to always remember is that while it is possible to change, it won't be easy. If you've lived your whole life this way, you can't just turn around and be super optimistic in a day. So don't have unreasonable expectations, because failing to live up to them will just create more negativity. Take it one day at a time. By taking small and consistent steps, you will become a stronger, happier person before you know it. Understand the outcome of negativity. This is the first step you need to take before you can start changing your attitude. Carefully read the consequences of having a negative attitude. You can find them in the details below. And always keep them in mind when your mood goes down. Print them out and hang them somewhere in plain view. When we know what we have to lose, we tend to think twice before allowing ourselves to think or act in a certain way. Admit that there are problems. If you don't admit they exist, how are you supposed to get yourself into the right mindset in order to solve them? Accept the facts and the responsibility if you've been negative or inactive. This will make it easier for you to become positive. Denial is a dangerous thing that has no place in a non-pessimist's life. Try to understand what causes your negative attitude. Check the list of possible causes of pessimism that I provided in the details section. Do you see something familiar? Once you've identified where your problem lies, then all you have to do is find the right solution aimed towards solving that problem. Read through the rest of these tips. I'm sure you'll find something that will help you. Write down all your feelings about the event and how you responded to it. It's no harder or easier to change a mental habit than it is to change a physical habit. The only difference is that thoughts are more airy than a physical habit, and that makes them harder to pinpoint, thus harder to change. But if you put your thoughts down on paper, it makes them real, physical, and available to look at. So when you hit a small setback, write down how you explain it to yourself, then look at it. Have you overgeneralized? Have you seen the setback in its most unchangeable, permanent form? Don't try to look on the bright side. It's too early for that. That's too much of a jump way too soon. First, find out what's wrong with your pessimistic thinking. How and when are you doing it? These are things you're going to have to figure out before you can counter the actual pessimism. Keep doing this. Try to do it every day. Think of it as training. You're training your mind to think differently. Get rid of negative influences. There will always be people who regularly insist on bringing negativity into your life. Get rid of them, or at least the ones you can get rid of. I know you can't get rid of your family members or your co-workers, but you can limit your interaction with them, and you can ask them to leave you alone when they're being negative, or ask them to stop being negative altogether. Introduce them to these techniques. Maybe you can help each other. What's the worst that could happen? The negative people in your life stop talking to you? Or stop being negative? They're both good options, either way you slice it. Don't allow the negative attitudes in others around you. The main point here is to create a better social environment for yourself. It'll give you relief and help you move forward. If you let people around you moan and groan, you'll just get dragged down with them in the end. A secondary point here is that it's a great way to notice the kind of effect negative people have on others. Do you like those people? How do they make you feel? Would you like them more if they weren't as negative? Now you have an idea of how other people feel about you. Take a moment to step outside of yourself. The reason any of us feel bad about any given situation is because we tend to focus on our feelings, get absorbed in them, and become them. All we can think about is how that situation affects us, whether it does so directly or indirectly. So here's a tip. When something bad happens, focus on exactly what is going on around you and try to see it as somebody else would. Analyze the situation as it is, not as it affects you. You might see that it really isn't that big a deal after all. Let go of the theory that the world is against you or that you were just born unlucky. Honestly, guys, that's just an immature assumption that has no basis in reason or science. The universe has bigger problems than you to deal with. Stop being self-centered and think rationally for a second. Whatever happened was simply the effect of a unique set of circumstances. It seems like everything is against you because you associate each action and reaction with things related to you. Understand that the past does not equal the future. Just because you've experienced pain or disappointment in the past does not guarantee that you will experience it again. Of course, both pain and disappointment are a part of life, but what starts off badly does not necessarily have to end that way. Don't turn a bad start into a self-fulfilling prophecy for a bad ending, because I guarantee you that if you keep on thinking and saying it will, that's what you're going to see. Remember that life is too short and make the most of it. When you feel pessimistic, remind yourself that every minute you spend upset is 60 seconds of happiness you will never get back. You could have spent that time being happy about what you have, but don't complain about having wasted that time, because that just wastes even more time. If you think about it, pessimism is impractical because it causes you to waste time dwelling on things that haven't happened yet and aren't even guaranteed to happen. Plus, it prevents you from enjoying the good things that are happening at the moment. Pessimism is a waste of time anywhere you see it. And time is a limited resource that you can't afford to take for granted. Don't put yourself down when you catch yourself thinking unpleasant thoughts. If you attack yourself for this, you're only adding to the pessimism. Stop yourself when this happens. And instead, take a deep breath, focus, and say, oops. There I go again. It's only a habit you're repeating accidentally. Don't beat yourself up. You're gonna have to be willing to be nicer to yourself if you want to become less pessimistic and more optimistic. What's done is done. Move on. If things haven't been as positive as you would like them to be, then look at that situation as spilt milk. It's not possible to go and unspill it, but you can definitely clean it up if you don't like the mess it made. Don't invest time and feelings in events that are not worth it. Reflect a little bit if certain unpleasant things that have happened to you lately deserve the large amount of time and emotion you invested in them. Remember to only invest energy in things you can actually affect and change for the better. Everything else is just eating away at you. Don't panic ahead of time. Things are rarely as bad as they seem at first. Avoid jumping to conclusions just because you notice something that might be a bad omen. Just let it continue as it is if it's not bothering anyone. If it turns into something bad later on, deal with it then.